Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and I'm talking about the face and the frame. Every picture that looks great has a great frame around it. Everyone walks in the door, they want to look natural. They want to look pleasing. They don't want to look done. Usually you only see those people that look done. Those that are natural, you can't put your finger on why do they look natural. What is it? Do they even have anything done? They just look good. I'm going to talk about what the picture is, what the frame is, and then I'm going to go through the reasons for each part of the frame of why people aren't addressing them and what can be done. So the picture of the face, what are we talking about? We're talking about the brows, the eyes, the under eyes, the cheek, which is most commonly overdone because that's the low-hanging fruit to lift the face, and it can be injected with a microcannula now, and people can put large volumes. The nasal folds, the marionette or lower area, and even chin projection I'm not going to include because many people still aren't doing that. So this is the picture of the face. Why are people injecting here? Because that's where the trainings are done, the FDA approvals, the nasolabial folds. But most importantly, it's psychology. When someone spends money and goes home and looks in the mirror, they want to see where that money went. It's like you buy a car, it's in the driveway, you go out, you look at it, you enjoy it, you can even get in and drive it. But if you have something done in the front of the face, you can easily see it. There's my money. The frame, often you can't see unless you look sideways, unless someone does a 3D image and shows you, or unless your injector takes 5 views and looks at it. So you can't sit back and enjoy the look of it. However, what we miss out as the individual is that we're with people around us in 3 dimensions, and when they comment, oh, you look good. Oh, your skin looks good. Oh, you look natural. You've had things done, you look. They're looking at you not straight on, but from all those different angles. And those, as you can imagine, there's many more angles than the straight on angle that take you to 180 degrees. So let's talk about the frame and why it isn't being done. We'll start at the top. We always inject, we start at the top and work down. So we need to do the least amount of volume in the lower face. So the temples, there's a lot of confusion. It's number one, the reason that a lot of people don't do it is it takes volume. And I guess the second would be there's a danger involved. And no one really knows. There's not one technique that's foolproof. So either people do it and they don't know that it's dangerous, which is common, or they just don't do it at all, or they kind of bite their lip and do it a little bit, but not a lot. And then, of course, like I said, it takes volume to do, so it's expensive, but it looks great. So the cannula technique, the needle technique, and of course, you putting Sculptor on the bone with a product that you can pull back that's long lasting, that doesn't wear off as quickly as hyaluronic acid because it's a movement area. So that's the temple, and you can watch my videos on the temple filling and different techniques. But that's the reason, that's one of the main reasons. The next area of the frame would be the high lateral cheek. I think people do a great job here. They get that the lateral cheek is youth, it's beauty, and it's fertility. And most supermodels of the world have a high lateral beautiful cheek, and people who are older that look young, also because the bone holds the face up, has a high lateral cheek that people recognize. This area of the frame, the preauricular, is underdone. And the reason is, once again, like the temple, it's expensive and it covers a large surface area. But as you can imagine, that's where the facelifting is done and the signature of the surgeon is back here. With a filler, you don't have to have a signature of the surgeon. You can do it through micro ports, but you need volume to fill, to pull back, and there has to be a bit of a hollow. You don't want to fill it if it's already too fat. That's the one thing. The other thing is there can be a line of demarcation. So you can take your filler, you can add a little bit of water, and then you can cover some surface area. It does last fairly long, but it could easily be 5 to 7 vials of filler plus to fill that. You can get a line of demarcation and people don't fill it because of the expense. So that's the preauricular area, all important. The next area is the jawline. And you see that many people are now starting to fill the jawline. if you go look at before and afters and there's one or two vials done, it's unlikely you're gonna walk into a clinic and get that result on whatever before and after you saw with one or two vials. Think about what a vial is. Here, I'm putting one vial into a teaspoon. One vial is 1 ml or a fifth of a teaspoon. Now look at your jawline. Look at your preauricular, look at your temple, and imagine that one vial. What's it going to do? The best injector in the world can't make that look like 10 vials. And so the jawline is all important because it picks up the front of the jawline, or where people complain of the jowls. It creates a sharply, nicely demarcated jawline that everyone wants. We have to be careful not to square the lower face, but it is part of the frame. It is safe to do with a cannula if you know your anatomy. There's many choices of products, but it does cost some money, and that's probably the one reason that it's not done commonly. There you have several areas of the frame of the face that need to be filled in order to get a nice natural look, and some of the reasons why they're not being done. There's many reasons, and I'd love to hear if you had these procedures done, comment below. If you're an injector and you do them, the technique, or there's other areas of the frame that you want to talk about or techniques, let us know what you do below. I love the group of people that are subscribed here. We are all here to learn from each other. Pop onto my Instagram, subscribe to this channel to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.